Welcome to Viking basketball as Portland State gets ready to take on Northwest University tonight right here at the Viking Pavilion. I have head coach Barret Peery with me right now. Coach, we'll talk about Northwest in just a moment. The Vikings have one game under their belts at the University of Portland the other night, a very close game, a hard-fought game. UP put on a little run at the end and came away with the victory. Give us some reactions to that game.
Well, first of all, it was just fun to be on the floor. You know, I think it had been such a long time coming. I'll give you my reaction was is when we got there, and it reminded me so much of when I was in junior college. We would go play in these jamborees in Dallas and in Colorado and things like that, these early season games after a week of practice or 10 days of practice in early October. And that's exactly how I felt. And Jason and I have experienced that a lot. Skink and I have experienced that a lot, where we said to ourselves, it feels like a preseason junior college game because A, there was nobody in the stands, so it was preseason, and B, we'd only had about 5 or 10 practices. Our team had had 7, I think. And so it was just all kind of awkward and a little bit challenging. We got a lot of things done that I wanted to have happen. I got to play a lot of guys. I wanted to see a lot of guys under the lights, for lack of a better term, and get them out on the floor and get them experience and see how they reacted to things, put guys in some spots. But I would have loved to come out with a win. I was really concerned us never having been officiated yet this year in practice or in a game, and Portland having that for 3 games as well as in some practices. I thought that was an advantage, and you saw it in the foul count. We were silly with the fouls and put them on the line a ton, and I thought that was a difference in the game at the end, as you saw.
Yeah, it absolutely was. University of Portland took advantage late in the game. Ahmed Ali making 12 consecutive free throws, among others, and that kind of allowed them to make that late run. The Vikings, going into the game, you alluded to it, had played or practiced only about 8 times, and a little bit of sloppy play to start the game, but I think they played hard, but just kind of had some trouble overcoming maybe that lack of experience of being together.
Yeah, and just that court time together, experience together. You know, we got to that first media timeout, and I was literally just kind of like probably the first 2 timeouts, because there was a media timeout, then I took a timeout when they went up 14-2, and I was kind of like, everybody breathe, everybody just breathe, relax, settle in, we're fine. The ball wasn't moving, it was sticking, and people were trying so hard to get something done that we didn't look like a team. And it wasn't a selfish factor, it was just a trying so hard to get something done factor. And fix it as individuals as opposed to the team. We got that squared away a little bit, got it to 2 points at the half, took the lead a couple times in the second half, and then just didn't finish. I thought we got a little wore down, and then I was probably messing around with too many different combinations, trying to see people along the way and hoping that we could get away with that and get the win as well. But we as a staff and as well as players, we learned a lot from it, and we've had good film sessions the last couple days from it and got a lot out of it.
And the Vikings starting 5 brand new players to the program in that game against University of Portland did a pretty good job. We may see the same 5 again tonight, but Coach, you had to be pleased just from an individual talent standpoint. It looks like you recruited well. Monty Scott, 21 points. Elijah Hardy, 16 points, 4 assists. Our halftime guest tonight will be Khalid Thomas. He had 13 points, 6 rebounds. So you got some good production out of those new players.
Yeah, and we expect that. Those guys are experienced, and they've been good places, and they've been under the lights. And so I expect them to score and contribute all the time. As we go through, you know, tonight's game as well, you know, we want to try to mess with the lineups a little bit and try to get guys experience and see what combinations are going to work. It's really an on-the-fly type experience right now. You know, I don't like looking ahead, but, you know, you look ahead next week at this time, you and I will be sitting here talking about Weber State coming in, and it'll be like, whoa, we've played 3 games. So we need to try to get things done as far as learning about our team in a really, really quick fashion, and then also win. And so that's where we're at right now. And I want to see guys get to play, and I want to put them in situations where we know what we're going to have when it becomes really, really important. But it's going to be coming become important a lot quicker than normal.
Winning, that's the key always, and that leads us on to our opponent tonight, Northwest University. Northwest, an NAIA school. They play in the Cascade Collegiate Conference up from Kirkland, Washington. They've actually played 3 Division I teams already this year, lost all 3 games. The Vikings would seem to be pretty heavy favorites when you play a lower division school, but what are you trying to get accomplished tonight?
first win, like you said, definitely. We need to win. We need to win this game. We need to play right. It needs to look how it's supposed to look. Give them credit, though. They've gone out and played Portland. They've played Oregon State. They played Cal at Oregon State's event. And so they've got experience under their belt, and they have a team that's not a bunch of young kids. They have experienced guys. They can shoot the basketball, a couple good ball handlers that we can't let be wherever they want to be with the ball, handling it through the court. And then a couple big guys, you know, a skilled big guy that starts at the five that can stretch the floor and shoot the three. And I don't think they'll be wowed by anything as far as coming into a Division I school like this tonight, because they've already done that three times this year.
Vikings also with a pretty good size advantage, but comparative scores. Northwest played the University of Portland a little over a week ago and took them to the wire, the Pilots just beating them 74-69. So this is a team to be reckoned with.
No doubt. Can't take them lightly whatsoever, and I think the guys understand that. They'll be ready. They have the ability to shoot the ball and go on runs and scoring runs, and they had every opportunity to win a game at Portland a week ago. Like you said, they were right there.
All right, Coach, we hope to talk to you at the end of the broadcast tonight. It'll be Matt Rickert doing the honors, hopefully after a Viking victory. And stay tuned right after this. We'll be bringing you Viking basketball.